In this video, I'm gonna show you how to install and play Dragon Ball Raging Blast 2 online on your PC. The network was updated and all the online modes of Raging Blast 2 are working again. I'll show you how to fully set up the emulator and the network step by step so you can play online as well. Let's get started. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below. And here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide. And then just select here on continue. And there you go, we have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here, the link will be down below, and on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer, and then you just click on download PS3 update and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you want to go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and do not show again and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. As for getting the game, I can't show you here on the video where to go to get it. So you're gonna have to either dump your copy of the game into your PC or find it online. But this is something that I can't do because it's against YouTube's policy. And when you have it with you, go back to the emulator folder here, and inside there is this folder here called games that was already created when you installed the emulator. And this is where you're gonna be placing the game files. And you just have to extract it from the zip file that comes from, and inside this folder, there's going to be two files in here, the PS3 game folder and the SFB file. Leave it like this, you don't have to do anything else. Now, go back to the emulator here, and then click on File, and then click on Add Games. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you're gonna double click on the games folder, and then click once on the Dragon Ball folder here, and then click here on the bottom on select folder. And just like that, the game will appear here. Or you can just close the emulator and reopen because it will scan the games folder and the game should appear as well. Now we are going to configure the RPCN network to play this game online and create an account. So here on the emulator, you're gonna click here on configuration and then click here on RPCN. This window will show up and you're gonna start by clicking here on account, and then here you're gonna click on create account, and first you're going to create your username account right here. So select the name that you want to use and then click on OK, and here you're gonna type the password that you want to use, of course, then click on OK, and lastly you're gonna type the email that you have so you can receive the token code, so you can access the online functionalities of RPCN and play the game online. Click on OK and this window will show up saying that you have created your account, but you need the token code on your email to activate your account. So head over to your email inbox and you're gonna receive a message exactly like this one that says your token for RPCN and then the code right here. So obviously you're gonna copy your code as such and paste your token right here and then select OK. Now the username that you have created is going to show up right here. So lastly, just click here on test account to make sure that everything worked fine. And there you go. You're gonna see this message here saying your account is valid. You're good to go now. So click on OK and you can close this down too. You notice that there is a friends option here available, and you can actually add other people that also have a RPCN account to play with them online. So if you know someone that wants to play online as well, you just have to click here on friends and then click on add friend and then type his ID right here and then add him and then add that person as a friend. And to complete this, you're now going to right click here on the game and then click here on create custom configuration. Now go to the network tab here, and under network status where it says disconnected, you're gonna click on it and change from connected. The DNS and the bind address should be left as this one right here. You don't have to change it. And on PSN configuration, you're gonna change the PSN status from disconnected to RPCN. Now the game is ready to go online. And since we are here on the configuration tab, we can also change the game settings on the emulator to make the game run and look better too. So start by clicking here on the GPU tab, and on renderer, make sure that Vulkan is selected here. But if your GPU is outdated, you're probably only gonna have the OpenGL option here. The game works on this renderer as well, but the performance won't be as good as it is on the Vulkan renderer. So keep that in mind. But if it's available, go ahead and select Vulkan here. On an isotropic filter, you can change this one from auto to 16x. This will make the game look much better and has minimal impact on performance. And if you want to increase the game internal resolution, keep the default resolution at the recommended here, 720p, and change it here on the resolution scale. This game is already well optimized on the emulator, so in my case, I could even play this at 4K resolution at 300%. And I was hitting 60 FPS. But of course, this is gonna depend on how strong your GPU is. So keep messing with this until you get a good quality that doesn't affect your performance. Next, this part is optional here, but I like going on the emulator tab here and disable the show trophy pop-ups, the PPU compilation hint, and the shader compilation hint. They can be annoying, especially the shader compilation hint, because every time the emulator is doing them, you're gonna get a notification on the bottom of your screen. And I think that's annoying, so I just come here and turn them off. But that's up to you, of course. And just like that, we are done here on the settings. So click here on apply and then save custom configuration. And now the only thing left to do is configure your controller. So you're gonna click here on pads, and this emulator has an automatic mapping function. So if you already have your controller plugged in on your computer, you're gonna click here on handlers and select the device you want to use. In my case, I have an Xbox controller, so I'm gonna click here on X input, and just like that, the emulator would do the configuration for me. But if you want to change individual inputs, you just have to click here on the button you want to change, and then press the button on the controller. You can use your keyboard as well if that's what you want to do here. It will work just as fine. Now we are ready to go, so click here on save. And to start, you just have to double click the game here. And when you start it for the first time, it's going to compile this PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long and you only have to do this once. And if everything is correct, you're gonna see that message up there on the screen that successfully logged on RPCN. And just like you would normally do to play this game online on an actual PS3, you just have to press here on the online battle. It's going to connect to RPCN. And just like that, you are now online. And every game mode is working online here. If you want to play ranked or player match or freestyle or set up a custom tournament here on world tournament as well. And you can also invite your friend to your lobby as well using the RPCN feature that I showed you at the beginning of the video. Even the online ranking is working as well here, just like it was on a PS3 here. These are all players who got this on RPCS3 and played this online here as well. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC, focusing on the best graphics and performance. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and check out my other stuff. Thank you for watching, have fun playing Dragon Ball Raging Blast 2 online, and I'll see you soon.